Hey there and welcome back to Mass Effect, my name is Pete and today we finally complete the last bit of Feros. In the last episode we escaped Exogeny headquarters and we also already got introduced to the Thorian Creepers. I already explained that we're going with the Paragon approach to this part of the mission and leave the colonists alive, and so let us now summon the elevator that will bring us into Zeus Hope, because our goal for this episode lies beneath the colony. Alright, heading out of the elevator, we have two more Thorian Creepers here, and a third one will come through the doorway in a second. We want to stay here for the fight because behind the doorway we also have colonists armed with guns, and we want to save those for last. The fight here is pretty straightforward. The lift a few seconds ago gave us some nice breathing room that allowed us to take two creepers out without much resistance, and the third one here will also not be able to get up before he gets killed. Now onto the colonists, and like I said earlier, we're going to leave these two alive. We're also going to save the anti-Thorian gas grenades and simply knock them over. That has the same knockout effect without killing them, and that's two Paragon points for each colonist. By the way, if you're wondering where those points are, we get them at the end of the mission, so then we hopefully get a nice boost of 32 Paragon points. Over here, you're normally able to grab two instant kills by throwing these two creepers off the top of the staircase. However, in this case, Caden was a bit unfortunately positioned, so we only got one and now have to deal with the second creeper from up here. Alright, great. Now we want to move in, activate a few more creepers, but then immediately retreat back up the stairs because there are a few more colonists with guns over here. With the creepers, we once again want to wait until they're at the top of the stairs, then use throw, and this time Rex gets the double kill. Once again, there's only one creeper on the ground left. Now one more time onto the colonists, and this time we're going to use the grenades for the first time. We could have theoretically also meleeed these colonists into submission, however they have a tendency to get knocked back into the freighter structure in the back, or in one of my previous attempts at this I apparently took a bit too long, and Rex and Caden for some reason decided to start killing them. Now for this next group we're also using a grenade that removes two colonists and two creepers very nicely. Again, only one more creeper remains, and yes, I did not overlook the upgrade kit. There is a crate with a total of 5 grenades in there at the bottom of the small staircase that we just went up, but I want to grab those at the latest possible point, because otherwise we would unnecessarily waste grenades. Again, the next group of creepers is surrounded by colonists, plus they are in a very open area with not much cover for us to hide behind, so let's instead lure them over here, and the small staircase followed by the corner with the two blocks also creates a nice choke point. The lift gives us 3 instant kills, and that is enough for us to level up again. With Shepard we continue in commando, increasing weapon damage further. With Caden we spend our first point in medicine, unlocking neural shock, actually a very interesting ability against Thorian creepers, and then for Rex we'll continue as usual with shotguns. And here we get a first look at Caden's neural shock ability. Its main use against the creepers is that it knocks them down instantly. They have a rather large health pool, so it doesn't do much in terms of damage, but since the creepers take so incredibly long to get back up, every ability that has a knockdown effect is immensely useful against them. You can also see now why retreating here is a very solid strategy. We already killed 3 creepers and they are still rushing in. Fighting this out on open ground surrounded by the colonists could go very wrong very quickly. The lift here gives us another quick kill, and then we have only one creeper left who also doesn't last long. Now once again we're facing 4 colonists in 2 groups of 2 each. The first 2 we can knock out, and for the second pair we can use the anti-Thorian gas grenade. Wonderful, and that clears the area and keeps all 16 colonists alive. Let's now activate the crane controls and open our way to the Thorian.
I tried to fight it, but it gets in your head. You can't imagine the pain. I was supposed to be their leader. These people trusted me. It wants me to stop you, but I won't. I won't!
So So despite all of our efforts, one colonist did meet his early demise. Fidan, in a last move of resistance against the Thorian, just killed himself, which I think gives us more than enough reason to finally go down below the colony and get rid of the Thorian. However, before we do that, let's restock on anti-Thorian grenades, and we can do that with the upgrade kit that we just passed earlier. Wonderful, we are now back at the full capacity of 8 grenades, and while those anti-Thorian grenades are primarily designed to take out the colonists in a peaceful manner, they are also instant kill devices against the Thorian creepers. And while we don't have to deal with the colonists anymore, the danger that goes out from the creepers is far from over. And we just received the reward for not killing a single colonist, 32 Paragon points, which brings us either very close to or even above the threshold for the Paragon morality assignment. Either way, we are close to unlocking that and should now, whenever possible, focus on accumulating as much renegade points as we can. But first of all, let's meet the Thorian.
Okay, by the numbers, we just need to find... What is that?
Well, looks like taking out the Thorian might not be as easy as it sounds.
We are going to need bigger guns.
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. 1,000 feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
No matter how we react here, we're going to trigger a fight, so we might as well take 2 renegade points on the way with us.
You enslaved the colonists. You destroyed their minds. I don't know what Saren wanted with you, but I just want you dead.
The Thorian is a piece of this world, extending across the land and back through the ages. You can no more kill it than cut the sky. Your blood will feed the ground into new growth!
Alright, it's actually possible to throw the Asari off the ledge here for an instant kill. However, you have to time that correctly, and as you can see, I did not manage to pull it off. That's not too much of a problem though, as long as we keep her immobilized, and the lift does the trick, and shortly after we get the kill. Now, what remains are a few Thorian creepers, and that is how the next 15 minutes or so will go. We are slowly going to fight our way upstairs, and we will have to dispose of a ton of creepers on the way. The Thorian also has several of these Asari clones, and they will also harass us in regular intervals. Alright, we just discovered a Thorian node, and those are basically our main objectives in this fight. These nodes are what anchors the Thorian in the tower, and you will soon see that it really needs them. There are several of these nodes throughout the tower, all of them protected by creepers, and also by the occasional Asari clone. Now, as you should be able to see by the sheer number of creepers that we're facing here, this can be an extremely challenging fight on insanity. For that reason, even though it fits with the storyline, I would absolutely not recommend doing Feros first with a low-level character. I like to save it for last after Therum and Novaria, both because of this fight, and also because of the pretty high requirement in the charm and intimidation skill that is needed to convince Ethan Jong to help the colony. If you remember, we did that in the last episode. Now, with the last creeper down, we can now focus on the Thorian node and see what happens if we shoot at it.
That hurt. I can tell. A few more of those and it's in trouble.
As we go up the stairs here, we pass a few more creepers. However, we don't have to worry about those for the moment. Alright, the Thorian throws another Asari clone at us, but for the moment we don't want to engage her. Instead, let's activate and lure out a few more creepers and then retreat back down the stairs. While the creepers will normally rush forward towards us, the Asari clones on the other hand tend to hold their positions, so we can safely deal with all the creepers and then take out an isolated Asari. And here, once again, a quick showcase of why bringing two biotics to this fight is extremely useful. A lift from Kaden gives us two instant kills by crushing two creepers against the ceiling. Now, the only enemy left in the area is the Asari clone. Kaden can use warp on her. That makes her extremely vulnerable, and a few seconds later she falls to our assault rifle. As we continue onwards, we activate a few more creepers. These ones are actually guarding another Thorian node, and it is theoretically possible to just rush forward past the creepers and take out the node directly. That would kill all of the creepers in the area instantly, because the creepers actually belong to certain nodes, so the node is kind of what keeps them alive, and destroying the node therefore also destroys the creepers. However, the major downside to that strategy is the loss of experience points, as killing the creepers by destroying the node will not give us any experience points for the creepers themselves, and since the creepers at this point do not pose too much of a challenge, we of course want to grab the XP. Now we have only two more creepers left to defeat, and you might have already spotted the locker in the back. Now, while I have no idea how a fully stacked weapon locker remains intact in these surroundings, we will certainly not complain. And with the last creeper now taken care of, let's have a look at what's inside. Alright, two pistols and a shotgun. In one of my training runs, I actually grabbed a pretty nice assault rifle here. With this, we could maybe upgrade Kaden a bit, but it's not a necessity. Instead, let's get rid of another Thorian node, and that spawns a few more creepers as well as another Asari clone. The first creeper right here positions himself perfectly for a throw of the ledge for an instant kill. However, we also get knocked down quickly by the Asari clone. One more difference between her and us is though that we have one more throw available. And with that we can catapult her as well as a Thorian creeper off the ledge for two more instant kills. What remains is a very low health bar on Shepard, but also only one more creeper. So with only one more enemy to take down here, we will of course not waste any medigel. Alright, we can already see the Thorian node in the back, surrounded by more creepers, and so let's go in for another round. By firing at the Thorian node here, we can actually kind of control how many creepers we activate. If we were to simply rush in, all of them would attack us. However, if we only deliver a few pot shots against the node, only a slight handful will get up, and the rest will wait until we deal more damage. Now if you think back a few minutes, in Zeus Hope we actually saved a few gas grenades, and we did that specifically to use them in the fight against the Thorian creepers. So after a throw by Kaden pins all of the creepers here in one place, let's chuck in a grenade as well. And that did not go as expected, to be honest. Three or four creepers actually made it out of the blast alive. Well, in that case we'll stick to the good old assault rifle. Another thing that becomes very obvious here is how incredibly monotone this fight is if it is approached with a good strategy. At least at our current level, the creepers are not more than bullet sponges with the occasional tendency to fall over, and basically the fight against the Thorian and its slaves does not really increase in difficulty. I think maybe something like a higher level version of the Thorian creeper would have been an interesting idea. Maybe, for example, along the lines of the Geth Hopper, a creeper that just hops around, is incredibly hard to hit, and whose acid spit might not hit as hard but is able to hit you from a longer range. Alternatively, I also think a Krogan-like creeper would have been cool, so a creeper that is far more massive than the normal one, and therefore also doesn't tip over as easily, and can for that reason much more easily run in and knock you over. Just imagine how that would increase the tension. You enter a new area, a cutscene plays, and you see this massive new enemy surrounded by normal creepers, maybe similar to the Brood from Mass Effect 3, although maybe not as big. Just all in all, what I want to say is really that I think they could have done a bit more with this level. Now back to the actual gameplay, we have already taken care of the third node here, and there is also only one more creeper that stands between us and the way onwards. With him out of the way, we can now proceed, and the happy news at this point is that we're more than halfway through. With the third node down, a third Asari clone steps on the scene. Every time we take down a node, a new clone appears, and once again we take a bit of a hit here. Because the Asari clones are linked to the destruction of the nodes, we actually have another reason, apart from saving experience points, to leave the nodes be and only destroy them when all the creepers are taken care of. Now, because the creepers are already rushing in while the Asari clone has not been taken care of yet, we will actually go for a slight tactical retreat here, at least so that there is no line of sight between us and the other end of the small hallway. Now, with the creepers out of the way, we have a more or less clear path to the Asari, that is, at least until more creepers show up and block the way. We will ignore those as good as possible. The Asari clone is the priority target in this case, and we have already successfully hit a lift on her, so of course we don't want to let that go to waste, and well, because the creepers are rushing in, we can knock them down and get a clear line of fire at the Asari clone, which eliminates her pretty swiftly. Lovely. That now leaves us with only two Thorian creepers, who are already knocked down to the ground, nothing we can't handle, I think. Alright, that is the area cleared for the moment. We have more Thorian creepers over here to the left, but we will leave those be for a second, and instead move towards the end here, where we have a medical station. Inside, a light armor, as well as a pretty nice omni-tool, and off-screen I quickly checked if we can equip that on Caden. However, it only provides a substantial cooldown bonus, and while that is larger than the one he currently has, his current omni-tool is a bit more well-rounded, and therefore he will stick with it. Now, onto the next round of creepers. And this should be the point where you get slightly annoyed by them. As you might be able to see on the minimap, we have a steady stream of enemies coming in, but the doorway here serves as a nice choke point, and thanks to some pretty nice weaponry, we are also able to kill off creepers at a decent rate, so we don't really have to worry about getting overwhelmed. On top of that, Caden's biotics still serve us formidably. I actually thought about bringing Liara along to have Singularity available, but then we would either lose out on Caden's tech abilities, which would result in us standing in front of a lot of locked containers and crates, or we would lose out on the absolutely dominating force that Rex is at this point. And while Rex isn't that useful as a biotic apart from the occasional warp or throw, his shotgun is equipped with not one but two rail extensions at this point, giving him a damage boost of over 50% and putting his weapon damage very close to 400. Add to that another 40% damage boost to organic enemies thanks to the shredder rounds, and Rex is simply put a damage output beast. I can hardly wait until we find the first batch of high explosive rounds, because that will turn his shotgun into a literal cannon. And now maybe someone can help me out in the comments with this. I know that I said earlier that eliminating the Thorian node will also kill all creepers around it. Now, while I have tested it, and it is definitely true in some areas, right here the creepers seem to be absolutely unfazed by the destruction of the node. I don't really know what the deal is here, maybe some of you have the answer. Now we are once again left with two creepers, who we should be able to quickly dispose of, and then, as you can see on the minimap, the next group of enemies is already preparing. And with both creepers down, let's move up and continue the fight. A throw here not only pushes a creeper off the ledge for the instant kill, but it also immobilizes the fourth Asari clone, which leaves us plenty of time to follow up with a lift and then get rid of her. And once again, we are now left with a reasonably manageable amount of creepers. Coming up next is also Thorian node number 4, and small spoiler alert, there are only 5, meaning that we're getting somewhat closer to the end of the fighting. Right here we lose Caden, however, which is actually not the first time this has happened. Just a few moments ago I actually had to revive him with Unity. I don't know if you caught that. In this case we can save the Unity for later though, because the creeper that killed Caden was also the last in the area, and for that reason we are officially out of combat now, and Caden is already back with us. After getting rid of the fourth node, we find ourselves back in a staircase surrounded by inactive creepers. And those creepers will actually not stay passive for long, so it's a good idea to proceed very, very slowly. And right as we reach the bottom of the next stairs here, we get ambushed. Our first kill gives us enough XP to level up, but let's take care of that once we're done fighting. Lift once again proves to be very useful in getting rid of the Asari clone, as it pushes her out of the small window here and gives us another instant kill. We get two more quick takedowns by throwing two creepers off the staircase, but we still have a lot more coming in. And one thing that I seem to have overlooked a bit in this fight is the fact that we still have a bunch of anti-Thorian gas grenades left, so let's put one of them to good use. A short break in the action, let's quickly level up. With Shepherd we max out Commando, giving us a bonus to Assassination, which we don't have yet. With Caden we have a few options here, but I would like to work myself towards at least Advanced Neural Shock, and then we'll have to see how many level ups we'll get after that. And then last but not least, as usual, with Rex we continue in Shotguns. Now we can head up the stairs and make our way towards the last Thorian node. Yes, the fighting is almost over. Now here's something interesting. You might have noticed that we just received 430 experience points for killing 4 Thorian creepers with a gas grenade. That comes down to roughly 108 experience points per creeper. However, and this is very interesting, the normal Thorian creeper would only give us 86 experience points, at least on the level that we're currently at. So either I have overlooked something here, or the Thorian gas grenades actually give us more XP. Now, one more interesting bit is that we're fighting another Asari clone here. That in itself is not too spectacular, however it is certainly a change if you consider the fact that up until now, the destruction of a Thorian node would always spawn one Asari clone. In this case, between the destruction of nodes 4 and 5, there are actually 2. Combine that with the clone that spawned at the very beginning of the fight, and we have actually fought 6 Asari clones in this entire video. Now, with the Asari gone, the only thing that's left is a plethora of Thorian creepers, and since we have already lost Caden, and I have no interest in losing Rex or even dying with Shepherd myself, let us go back and retreat for a second. Now it does seem like only a handful of creepers remain, and in fact this group right here is quickly taken care of, however the onslaught will shortly continue. In the meantime I have brought Caden back, we can definitely use a bit more crowd control here, and with only the occasional throw by Rex we're not going to last long in this fight. Now as you can see we have no more red dots on the minimap, meaning no more active enemies, and we could actually go and destroy the Thorian node right now and end this fight once and for all. However, that would lead to the loss of quite a few experience points, so of course we're not going to do that. Instead, just shooting at the node for a few more times activates a few more creepers, and we can continue the onslaught. A few seconds later, Caden goes down once again, but since we're almost done here we don't need to bring him back. Now 2 more creepers fall, and despite the fact that there is one more sitting at the far end, I somewhat stupidly made the decision to destroy the node right here. I hope you forgive me for the loss of 86 experience points.
I should thank you for releasing me.
Alright, we are done. And we now have only one pretty long but also pretty revealing conversation in front of us, which we should probably start with the obvious question here.
How did you end up inside that thing?
My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
Also, no matter which dialogue choices we make here, the conversation will go largely the same. There is only one real decision at the very end.
Are you saying Saren can control minds?
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
Typical Asari meddling. About time it bit you in the ass.
Rex Snide comment aside, it still seems very interesting that someone as powerful as an Asari matriarch would fall for that.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks. But in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian, to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
So if that's the case, do you mind explaining why there were like a bazillion Geth here trying to destroy the Thorian?
Then why were the Geth trying to destroy the Thorian?
After Saren had what he needed, the Thorian became a liability. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
And what might that cipher be?
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. You must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. It watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
Interesting here that because of her former alliance with Saren via Benezia, she of course knows what happened on Eden Prime.
So the Thorian taught Saren to think like a Prothean. How?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory. A viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sense this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I meld it with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
Well, I figure if Saren was able to access it, then there has to be some kind of way.
You taught Saren, you can teach me.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity. I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
What just happened? Are you okay?
I honestly don't know how to answer that, but for the moment at least it seems we are.
I saw something. It still didn't make any sense.
You have been given a great gift. The experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
You look pretty rough. We should get you back to the ship.
I'm sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
And now onto the investigate dialogue tree. Depending on our decision at the end of this conversation, this might be the first and last opportunity to investigate. In any case, let's ask about the mysterious conduit first.
Do you know what the conduit is, or where it is?
No, I'm sorry. All I know is that Saren believes the conduit was the key to the Prothean extinction.
Well then whatever it is, we can't let him have it.
You have the cipher. In time your visions will clear, they will lead you to the conduit. I only pray you find it before Saren does.
Yeah, speaking of Saren, you have spent a bit of time on his side, I suppose. Anything you can tell us?
What else can you tell me about Saren?
There is little I could tell you that you do not already know. He's powerful, he's charismatic. And he is dangerous. Once I followed him, blind to his true nature. But now I see he is leading the galaxy into an age of darkness and suffering.
And just for the sake of completion, even though it doesn't really matter now that it's dead, any more information on the Thorian?
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped me, I became part of it. but I still don't truly understand it. So alien, so ancient. Its exact age is impossible to know. It measured time differently. 10,000 years of hibernation broken by a few frantic centuries of activity. Its mind was awesome, magnificent. It transcended all classification. And now it is gone.
Do I hear a little bit of remorse there?
Don't tell me you feel sorry for that thing.
The Thorian was a unique life form. A sentient being that lived for 50,000 years, maybe more. There is nothing even remotely like it in the known galaxy. I am grateful you saved me from a life of thraldom. Yet I cannot help but feel some sorrow for the loss of such a rare and remarkable creature.
And now, last but not least, let's ask her about herself because, well, we always do that.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly two centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous. But I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
And now, with everything safely investigated, we can lead things up to the big decision.
Now that you're free of the Thorian, what are you planning to do next?
If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
Now, we could choose to kill her for 9 renegade points right here. That would be in line with my plan to grab as many renegade points as possible. However, letting her live has, in my opinion, positive consequences for the colony now, as well as for Mass Effect 2 and 3. And for that reason, we will spare her life.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
I can't believe it. Jong says we'll have all the money we need to keep this place running. It's because of you, Shepard. I can't thank you enough.
And here we are now. We have completed Feros, and it was quite a ride. This turned out to be a pretty long episode, but I really, really didn't want to split the fight against the Thorian in 2 parts. But with that fight out of the way, we are now ready to take on new adventures. There are still a lot of side missions that we could do, and I actually have a few of them in mind already. So let us now make a cut here. I can say thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.